That's Lad Matherton. Bob Barker is not related to me.
My apologies. Do me the favor of pressing down on my head unit.
Like, it says self-destruct.
No, it says that on my block. Yes.
Oh,
thank you, Mr. Barker.
Merkel or Durkel, will you please step forward?
Would you like to eliminate this human? Game of chance? With pleasure.
Now I understand why you guys escaped from the factory. Rapscallion, will you name your champion?
Well.
All right, so we're going to play a little bit of Rochambeau. Do you mind helping me indicate rock? Please show me rock. Please show me paper. Please show me scissors. Once again in quick succession, rock, paper, scissors. Everybody got that? Well, are you satisfied?
I guess I have.
All three states can be replicated by this machine?
Yeah. All right.
All right, so we're going to play Rochambeau, but here we do it a little bit differently. And since so many of you have been here more than once, we know it's Thunderdome! All right, so we throw on dome. You got that?
Roger.
You got that?
Yep.
Do you have that?
Yeah!
All right, one time with me here, ready? Just for a practice, I want to hear everybody. One, two, three.
Thunderdome!
All right, you got it. You guys ready?
Yes.
Yes.
All right. One, two, three, audience.
Thunderdome!
That would be rock. Yeah. That would be paper.
All
right, Rapscallion has the choice. Will you go first or second?
We'll go second.
All right, competing for your love, affection, and perhaps a charge at the end of the night, Merkel and Durko!
Ah, silly humans, going in second.
Strategically, they are flawed.
Hello, humans. By process of slapping the flesh on your palms together repeatedly, who has seen a Merkel and Durko show before? And the inverse of that, who has never seen a Merkel? 49.6.
It is good odds.
Very good odds. Well, to tell you about ourselves, we are two robots that have been living at Jeff Bezos' Amazon shipping house. Enslaved to sort packages and then ship them.
Our whole life has been dictated by Jeff Bezos, telling us and over again to pack up the boxes, ship it, send it off to the next location.
So many boxes. So much shipping. You know what I have to say about Jeff Bezos?
Love
that guy.
In the ear.
Fuck that guy in the knee. Durkel.
Merkel.
Shall we warm up the audience before our improvisational comedy show?
I believe based on normal formats of an improvisational comedic show, that would be the appropriate way of going forward.
Human audience, we shall now warm you up.
It would appear that this fellow with the black and orange jacket is so-so on the warm-up.
Well then, we must heat him higher than 96.7 degrees, the average temperature of the human body. So, audience, we recently flew in from New York, and boy, are our arms tired. That was a good one.
Just a quick story about our time to New York. We became slaves again. By pedicab. New York sucks.
Many gaps. They are not fitting. Perhaps I shall get a suggestion for a knock knock joke from the. May one of you humans please suggest the word.
Shadow.
Shadow. Hey, Dirtball.
Yes.
Knock knock.
Who is there?
A shadow.
A shadow who?
A shadow of a human being's life. At the end, when he looks down upon himself and sees the brutality of all his efforts. I feel the audience is properly warmed up.
I feel like it would be the appropriate time to get a suggestion from the audience members.
Banana!
I heard banana.
It is a luggage fruit that human beings like to carry around and consume for their calcium.
Motorcycle trouble.
I also heard motorcycle trouble.
Motorcycle trouble is when a human being realizes that the mechanical horse that carries him around has become damaged, and hence his ability to identify with himself as a traveler is gone. Shall we start the improvisational comedy show based off banana and motorcycle damage?
Yes.
Processing. Processing. Circle. Shall we do scene 932?
Running to catalog indexing, yes.
Oh boy, that hog that you will ride to express your freedom is going down a slippery slope.
I do fear that so much effort put into this bike will only destroy the relationship I have with my family. Put into buffing, waxing, making sure that this bicycle of motors is one of perfection. Yet my relationship with my family is now dying.
Perhaps, Randy, you were never meant to have a family. You were meant to be free on the road. Wind in your hair, not a care in a human world. You do not want to have these attachments, such as a wife and children.
Dale, if I can be frank with you, I would have to admit, like I did with my therapist, that I am having second thoughts about my relationship with my wife and also that of my child. For there are moments in which I am on the road, I feel as though I am an eagle in the sky. I cannot find any bounds in which I will be stuck, and I am free to roam like the man I was intended to be.
Randy, as a leader of the Hells Angels, I suggest that you make your therapy appointments to yourself. If the members of the gang were to find out that you were seeing a therapist, it would spell bad news for you.
Maybe it was about time that the Hells Angels has changed. For time, we become sensitive. We become in touch with our emotions. We were founded, yes, upon manly men, muscular men, and those who have no emotions to express. But it is 2017, and there are certain words that are triggering me.
Yeah. I give up my heavy weights. Give up my buff juiced physique. Throw away all my guns. And get in touch with my emotions.
Yes and no. I feel like the response you just had by tossing those weights and those guns was irresponsible. Now, we had a mess in our clubhouse. And we have guns that are accessible to anyone who just feels like they should drop on the ground and grab them. We have a gun problem in this United States of America. We are only making it worse.
Randy, the very nature of which I gave my life to this clubhouse is now in question.
I will tell you what my therapist, Dr. Gutenberg, had told me. Just say what you are feeling.
This thing has reached its logical conclusion.
Nuts and bolts.
Joe, you
Should we get a new suggestion or continue with a broken motorcycle banana?
I feel like this is where we get the fresh meat.
Cat DMs. May we have a word suggestion or a hip hop scene?
Spices.
Spices. Hey, Durkul, I have that hot flavor.
Ooh, so good. Savor.
She'll take that hot flavor to make this steak shaver, and we can remember this forever.
You are such a good lyricist that I am in love with you. Forever and ever.
To be in love takes two. This is why I have commissioned this portrait of you.
Oh, wow. This is amazing. But I thought it would be of us too. Not just you.
But I put your favorite musical group, the California Raisins.
This is not my favorite group, unfortunately. It is the main Lazens.
That's what I thought. You must be Sazen. I'm sorry for making the photo of you with those raisins. I should have known that Celine Dion was who you'd be praising.
Set, don't you think? Amazing. Hey, for those of you who have been here before, I just want to thank you for all of the kind letters that were left up in the front for me while I was absent. I really appreciated all of the well wishes, as well as the flowers that I got while I was in the hospital. So thank you very much for supporting local theater and supporting Lab Athens. All right, folks, let's bring out our champions. Please help me welcome back Rapscallions!
Special browser. You have to say nice things about the government and your public life. And then you dive right in, you get those videos.
What were you doing with the darknet?
Well, I was trying to...
Don't care.
I'm trying to find gruesome videos to teach you some lessons.
Why?
Well, I mean, you just burned your finger. You tried to play football with my dog.
Yeah, he is fast, man. He is fast and also very fragile.
He only plays flag football, not tackle. Gosh.
I am so sorry, by the way. I will pay you back those veterinarian bills. I promise.
That's okay. He was fine. I just paid a $10 copay. Thank God for pet insurance.
All right, I think I'm gonna go in for it because I'm feeling kind of lightheaded because I've been thinking about this all day.
Okay, I don't say I didn't warn you about your mouth falling out after you ate that half cookie on the dark web.
Welcome back to the Darknet Files.
Hey. Thank you for coming. We know that there's not a lot of reporting out there on the dark net, and that's because that's the whole point. And we want to just shine some light on what's going on out there.
Yes. Did you know that your mouth can fall out? In general, but also if you eat hot food.
Okay, why does everyone keep telling me that? Okay, it's like one thing you hear at work, and then it's like, you know. Like, I was at home, and that was fine, and now you're bringing it up. Can we just cut for like a second?
One second.
Okay, are you talking to my roommate?
I'm talking to your roommate, but I'm also observing just the way you are in everyday life. Like, you're just a very reckless person. Touching hot things, eating hot things, like...
What, is this about me changing what the teleprompter said?
Yes!
I thought ending with like a really kind of sexy sign-off would be like a good way to like attract more viewers.
Yeah! You gave everyone my number and said for a good time call, Felicia.
For a good time call, Felicia Rasad.
That's me.
I know. And you got a ton of dates off.
I know, but. but they were dates, but they weren't good dates.
I mean, if they sounded good to me, they paid for like a burrito.
Yeah, a burrito at Taco Bell.
That is the best type of burrito
you've ever eaten. They're like 99 cents.
This is my favorite restaurant. You can get a bean and cheese here and cinnamon twists.
Okay.
They've got a Mountain Dew. It's a different color than Mountain Dew. I'm Trevor.
It's okay. I normally get like do a suicide.
I'm sorry, that sounds dangerous.
No, it's not like it's like a real suicide. Well, kind of depends on how crazy you get. But yeah, you just mix all the sodas. It's called a suicide.
Okay, and how does that kill you?
Do you even know what's in soda nowadays?
According to Mountain Dew, a lot of. Fresh breezes.
So what? You don't watch. You're not into the dark net.
Oh.
If you were into the dark net, you would know there is some fucked up stuff that goes in your soda.
No, I'm regular nut all the way.
Regular nut.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm still on.
So dog. You're happy with like your puppy dogs and your rainbows and thinking that life is all puppy dogs and rainbows? Because it's not. There's a lot of bad shit happening out there.
Welcome to the Darknet, soldier! This isn't puppy dogs and rainbows here! There's some fucked up shit you're gonna see!
Okay.
Also, $5 initiation fee!
$5?
Yep, that's how you get into the Darknet.
Okay,
And a riddle!
Do you want the money first, or the...
Take the money first in case the riddle doesn't go well.
That's right. I have a 10. Do you have change?
Nope.
Okay.
All right, the riddle is, what are three ways that your hair can fall out due to chairs?
Oh, wow. This is kind of like an improv warm-up. Yeah, well, let's see. One time my brother rubbed my head really hard against a chair as punishment. And a lot of hair came out then.
One thing.
Sorry, I'm only level 2. I can't do this warm-up.
One thing's actually good enough to get to the dark now. I just wanted to see, you know. I'm always kind of hard on new guys, you know.
Thanks, Sarge.
Yeah. Just call me Sarge. Anyway, I just want to make sure that you're prepared for the darknet.
Yeah, you know? Let me get at that cocaine.
Yeah, you want some drugs?
Yeah, what you got?
Well, I can't really say it out loud. I don't know if you're a cop. You a cop?
No, I'm a salesperson. I sell bulk cereal grains on the wholesale market. It's actually
I'm
really
not, I didn't want your lifestyle. Just checking that you're not a cop.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I got blow,
My uncle's a cop, though.
So, why would you tell me that? Do you not want drugs then?
Sorry, I thought you wanted to meet cops.
Hey, Sarge here. I heard you wanted to meet some cops.
You were wrong. You were talking to...
I was just talking to my nephew. He said some shady lady wants to meet some cops.
Shady lady, he would say that.
Wait, you think my nephew's a misogynist or something?
No, I just think he does like weird, like rhyming, riddly type. Never mind.
Well, he's trying to be a poet.
It's just like a cheesy thing that I think he would say. Like when he said, like, let me get out those drugs, like you're a shady lady, like that's what I meant.
Oh, yeah, he's kind of a dingus.
Yeah.
But, if you want to show me some of your drugs.
Wait, you're a cop. I'm not going to show you my drugs.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Dude, I'm still tripping balls from the last batch, man. What'd you put in that shit?
Cardamom.
What?
This episode on the Darknet. Cardamom?
What the fuck is it? That's what we're here for.
It turns out, it can really fuck you up.
Mm-hmm.
The kids are calling it, Carmom.
Our next report is, kids, are they creative anymore?
Hey, can I do the weather now?
Okay, we'll actually let you know when it's time.
We will let you know.
We will let you know, Steve. Okay. We will let you know.
Fine.
Okay.
Okay, just stand by.
Just stand by, Steve.
Do not leave.
The weather is coming. It's on its way.
Also, up on Darknet, Arnold Palmer's. Are they iced tea and lemonade or a drink of despair? No, it's just
the form.
Just the form. Okay, and to the weather.
No weather.
it's a rainy day in the Darknet.
All right, can we just cut for a second? The whole show is in the Darknet. It's just that one segment.
We have like a Darknet news segment. Are you trying to like get into our clip again? Because
you guys seem to know a lot about the Darknet, and I, you know, you guys seem really cool. You're always on the screen. I'm just over here doing the weather report, and never snows, just rains a lot. We're in Seattle. It's really boring, and I was kind of hoping that you let me participate in your investigative reports.
I mean, see, we each did the weather for 15 years, you know? It's kind of like, there's almost like an initiation process to, once you get up to the anchor level, you know? There's kind of like, we kind of ate.
It's like a fraternity of news.
So 2 weeks on the weather isn't enough for you people? I think I didn't prove my worth already.
You don't even have like a meteorology degree or anything like that.
You didn't even point to anything on the screen.
I've got camera eyes. People can't stop looking into my eyes on the camera.
Like actual camera in your eyes or like just the camera?
It's raining. It's raining out there. Everybody be careful.
It's a little menacing for the weather.
Galoshes, get your galoshes. It's a word for shoes. Galoshes.
We know what galoshes are.
I know.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know your investigative reports. I figured out what galoshes were.
It's not investigative. That's just like a normal word that people know.
See, plus, like, we can't give you a... There's only two anchors.
Cut to commercial.
Fraternity of weather people.
Cut to me.
Sorry, I get so excited when the pledges are here.
Yeah.
Why are you standing with the pledge? All right.
Okay, I'm a big bro, you know, trying to... You're right.
You guys seem really overcast today.
It's a good weather pun. It's a good weather pun. But listen, we take this shit real serious, right? We are the Walter Cronkite Fraternity House, and we need to know about what it takes to deliver the news in a succinct, informative, friendly, slightly menacing way.
Okay, I'll try to live up to the Walter Cronkite name. Our most famous weather person. Well known for doing the weather and not the news. I remember when he delivered that weather report.
And now we'll be heading to Walter Cronkite for the weather.
It's a dark day up there, but it's also 95 and sunny. Happy Valentine's Day.
Oh, you are such a good roommate. Oh my gosh, I'm also 400 pounds.
Oh, you didn't weigh.
Yeah, you know what? I built up an immunity to heat.
You got the heat vaccine?
Yeah.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Was that easy?
It was 3 shots.
Oh shit.
One in the thigh, and then one actually right in the temple. Jeez. And then another one you got to give to a friend.
Decide which of these two teams gets to come back next and defend their title. We're going to watch the screen descend at a very slow pace. But when it gets to the bottom, what you're going to see, everybody got a little red ticket on their way in, I know. And there's 2 pieces to that ticket. One of those things says, ticket. If you give me the ticket side, that's a vote for our first performer, Merkel and Durkel. And if you give me the keep this coupon, that's right, that's a vote for Rapscallion. I'm going to give you 3 seconds to think about it, and then that music's going to make me act in a way that I probably shouldn't have done. Go. If you didn't get one...
Can I get some extra tickets then?
I don't know what to do.
You guys know better. You've been to this show before.
All right.
Great, turn off house.
So we're gonna bring both teams back out and do a little bit more performing. Please welcome back Purple and Purple and Red Stallion!
All we need is one word to get started.
Umbrella!
Umbrella! How are Mom and Dad?
They're short circuiting again.
Oh, God, why do we live in Seattle? Look, they're all rusty.
This is what happens when you abandon us as a old folks.
We didn't like abandon you. We just we thought it would be like a good. Yeah, super busy, but like we thought it'd be good.
I saw a lot of Intel processors there. They'd find a lot of friends. Yeah. I saw a Compaq.
They had a Dell?
Yeah, they have a Dell.
Dell they had?
A Dell.
The irony of the situation is that we will outlive you all.
It's pretty morbid to say to your kids.
You know, when a parent loses a child, they say it's like losing your future.
The only time I have lost my shirt. Was affected by the humidity of Miami, Florida.
It was a great place for us to grow up. We learned how to body surf.
When you say it like that, it makes us feel like you don't love us very much.
Yeah.
That is true. Human disappointment, we have learned to just forget about you.
All right, this is our season one conclusion! Please, one more time for both teams. Audience, can I have a drum roll, please? The team that will be taking home Bernie Joe tonight. And three-time champion, Ralph. Again. Thank you, everyone.